What's up, guys? It's Jason. This is Justin, and welcome back to your Four Doors of Death. It sounds like a karate movie or something, right?
Insert the you know what I mean?
Oh, boom, the punch. Yeah. Cool. And today we're doing Brain Surgery. That's right. Oh. We're talking about Full Moon's Dr. Death. That's D-O-K-T-E-R.
Yes.
You got to mix it up, man. You mix it up. Now, look, this is a spinoff movie from, Retro Puppet Master.
Retro Puppet Master.
I guess retro spinoff, but in other words, that's where we first seen the amazing doll, Dr. Death, but now he's back. He gets his own freaking movie.
Right.
And we're going to talk about it real quick.
And I think it's the second standalone movie. We had Blade.
Blade.
The Iron Cross.
Yeah, that was a great one, by the way.
Dr. Death.
I mean, by great, we'll mean, well, we'll see.
You know, we'll see how it measures up. Stay tuned.
Yeah. And then at the end of this, we'll give you our rating. We're going to give you two ratings. We're going to give you our standard horror rating, and then we're going give you a full moody rating,
because
it's two different things, man. So, all right, what is the synopsis of Dr. Death? Not much. Let me tell you right now. Basically, a girl leaves California looking for a new start, she's an orderly at a Shady Oaks retirement home,
which is the perfect name for a retirement home.
100%.
There's probably 800 Shady Oaks across the country.
But this only has four people in it, which is great, right? They have four actual residents, and then they have a staff of four orderlies. They all look like they come right out of a porn movie. And
one of those residents, by the way, looks 40.
I like this retirement. You get full service, literally full service, right?
Well, you do.
And you don't have to be 700 years old, man. But hey, guess what? One of the residents in the Shady Oaks retirement home dies. They find a community chest. It looks like an old treasure chest, right? You pull out of Davy Jones' locker.
Right, I thought we got it from Goonies.
Very good, Goonies. And in the middle of it, there is Dr. Death doll, all right? And guess what? Shocker, he goes and kills everybody. And we'll give you a spoiler alert at the end. One of the girls that actually shows up there comes out to be his granddaughter, and she's actually looking for Dr. Death himself. Guess what? You found it. That's it. It's a total runtime of 59 minutes. I said that right?
59 minutes.
Yeah. Yes. So I don't even think that's a real feature length. It doesn't matter. It's full moon.
Full moon length, baby.
So are you ready for your four doors?
Let's go. You ready?
Kick it. Door one.
Door one, classic full moon, right off the top. So one of the uniqueness and one of the charm of the full moon franchise is that you'll get an up-close scene of let's take the bedroom scene, for example.
Oh, right.
She's coming back to give Papa some sugar, and right before she gets her throat cut, they use an entirely different woman to go up-close, full wig, and pretty terrible makeup.
Yes.
But you know what? That's one of the things you love about full moon. Is it hilarity?
You don't even care.
You don't even care, dude. Like, try to make sense of it, you're at the wrong franchise.
I love that. That's it, man. You know, where's our actress? It doesn't matter. You, holding the mic. Stand in. Put this wig on.
It's like after that scene, she went to, like, get a water, and she, like, washed her makeup off. And they're like, hey, we got to kill you now. She's like, fuck it.
All right, I'm back. All right. Yeah, so door two, 100% made for stoners, okay? And that's, look. Well, pretty much almost all full moons are made for stoners, right? You got Evil Bong 666, 777, 888. I don't even know that.
We could be here for 60 minutes talking Evil
Bong. Yeah, yeah. Oh, and I say Halloween. They got all types of stuff, too.
But Ginger Dead Man.
Oh, God, forget about it, right? But this one is definitely made for stoners. So if you get a little too blitzed while you're watching this, don't worry. Every 20 minutes, they do a flashback. And not a flashback to another movie, a flashback of what you just watched 20 minutes ago. So you can literally walk into this any time of the movie and get caught up. That's classic full moon. Thank you to, support the 420 community, I guess, man.
Please, out there, man.
All right, door three.
Piggybacking off that point, door three. Another 60-minute banger. It's made for stoners, like you said. But again, another 60-minute banger. So they make these movies so digestible, so fun, that, okay, you're looking for something to do? You think 59 minutes is going to, like, really deter you from watching? Of course not. You're going to watch it. You're going to enjoy it. And you're probably going to watch two more, three more, four more. And that's how these things
totally work. I watched it, like, at 7 o'clock at night. Yeah. I was done by 8. I'm like, what else? I got a whole night ahead of me. Right. So this is amazing.
Then you go Demonic Toys and all these other
things. Yeah, that's the bad part. They have about a library of, like, 59-minute movies. You just keep going down and down. It's not bad. It's actually a good
thing. They all got that full moon charm.
Freaking love it. All right, door number four. You know what? The payoff was totally worth the end. Because not only you get to see a super rad puppet, right? Which I'm actually thinking Dr. Death's in my top five. You know what I'm saying?
Ooh, he's up there.
Yeah, I love him. But you actually see a puppet that actually skins a person alive and then uses a full human as a puppet. Not talking strings. He jumps inside and steers this person with his what? It's like his guts, right? His intestines. Guts. That is the coolest way to end the movie I've ever seen. And like I said, spoiler, the girl at the end who becomes who is the granddaughter of Dr. Death, right? Who is like an old World War II medic, I believe, or something.
Sure.
It doesn't matter. They probably just thought that up 10 minutes ago. Right. But the cool thing is, he's like, my job is I'm going to reunite you with your other fellow puppets, which means one thing, more spinoffs. Yes! I'm so excited, man. So I guess on the lookout for a bunch more of these spinoffs. I guess I'm going to take them from the retro Puppet Masters or whatever, but it doesn't matter. They probably already shot them, written them, edited them, and all last week, by the way.
Right, and we piggybacking off all that.
Yeah,
we just talked about what was the baby after the demonic
tour? Oh, Baby Oopsie.
Baby Oopsie.
Yes.
Baby Oopsie was they shot part two in June and it was out in August.
I love that.
And then part three came out like a month later.
Yeah.
So they cooked these up.
They'll never make you wait.
Never.
You know what I'm saying? And they'll keep feeding your full moon, your hunger you have, and like I said, you're always sort of satisfied enough, man, what you get, right? All right, let's give this a rating real quick. Let's give it a standard rating. If this was just a horror movie, it wasn't full moon, I would probably, let me lead.
Okay.
I'd go 5 out of 10. All right, on your standard movie. What would you give it?
6 out of 10.
6 out of 10.
You're not going to show this to somebody getting into horror.
No.
You're not going to do that.
Let me write
You're
out.
You're going to show this to a seasoned vet that's never come across it. So.
But if this, now let's take that out, throw it away, and let's go a full moon rating, because if you know full moon, it's a special rating, right? You know what you're getting into pretty much, and it's something that, you know, once again, I would say majority of the movies are always above the 5.0 type of thing, but I'm going to give this, my full moon rating, an 8 out of 10.
Okay.
For sure.
And 9 bloody scrubs out of 10.
9.
Because I love Dr. Death's bloody scrubs.
This is amazing. This is a great movie. So there you guys go. You're Dr. Death. Full Moon's Dr. Death, by the way. Because I looked up Dr. Death. There's like 700 other ones,
man. Yeah, go figure.
But don't forget, D-O-K-T-E-R, right? That's right.
Working, I mean.
Yeah, whatever. So there you guys go. There's your 4 Doors of Death. We'll see you next time.